Okay, good morning S3 students. Welcome to this new virtual online lecture on public speaking and debating. I'm Professor Kui, the professor of this subject called public speaking and debating for semester 3 students. So today I'm going to start with demarcating the main points and targeting the main concepts and issues that we will be dealing through the semester. So, the title of the subject, or the name of the subject, is named Public Speaking and Debating. Thus, to talk a little bit briefly and concisely concerning the difference between oral communication and public speaking speeches. Of course, in S2 students who are introduced to how to speak orally, verbally, how to use verbalized language and spoken language to send messages or to share meaning with the receivers. But, and we have also detected that there are like different types and different trends of communication. So to start with oral communication can be divided to two, three, or four types, starting with interpersonal communication, means communicating or face-to-face communication or phone conversations, moving to intrapersonal communication, means speaking with yourself. It's a kind of monologue. But in public speaking, the speaker is talking or addressing or delivering his own speech to more than three individuals, and of course it can be formal or informal depending and based on the real context in which the speaker and the audience are interacting in. Okay, now so I'm going to introduce concisely and briefly the main points that we are going to discuss within semester concerning this subject. So the main topics or the main points that we are going to discuss have been taken directly from David Joseph, The Element of Public Speaking. So it's a book and you can find it in the libraries that are near the faculty, and we are going to highlight and focus on the four parts, the first four parts. So the first part, the second part, the third part, and the fourth part. From page 1 to page 347. So we are going to, discuss these parts, and we are going to shed lights on the most significant and practical points that are directly or indirectly, explicitly or implicitly interconnected with public speaking's speeches. So, of course, there are four parts I have just stated now. The first part entitled Elements of Public Speaking. So, in this first part, we are going to explore the what is public speaking and what is the main differences between oral communication and public speaking speeches. Of course, moving to the history, the definitions, the theoretical concepts and theoretical framework or general backgrounds that are directly associated with public speaking. Moving to the third important point, which is moving from apprehension to confidence, means how to speak impressively, fluently, in a very qualitative manner, in a highly skilled and talented way. Because public speaking is an oral speech, so, and of course, since it is an oral speech, most of the time speakers seek to either to inform or to entertain or to persuade or to inform or to impress or to excite to the receivers. And in this context of public speaking, most of the time the receivers or the receiver, okay, are the audience or the audiences in plural, as we are going to see later. And of course, moving to another point, which is listening, means the practicality of listening. Why listening is so vital in public speeches and moving to different types of public speaking. I said that public speaking can be formal or informal depending on the your own interaction within the different kinds and different types of environments or different spaces that you are going to deliver and to send your own messages to the other. The third or the second part, of the book, it will automatically highlight some notions or some topics that are highly significant and very interconnected with the public speaking speeches. So moving to the topic, the objective of the speech, and moving to the thesis. The thesis means your personal announcement or your main object, your main thought where you are going, what is the general, what is the very specific and a very concise and very accurate objective that you have in your mind. Since you are talking to the audience, most of the time speakers have certain objective in their own mind. So building on this fact, one should take into account that whenever there is a public speech or public speaking activity, automatically there is a speaker and there is an audience. So and the active part here within this process, it's the speaker, because the speaker is the one who is disseminating, sharing, talking, acting, and sending messages or data or information to the other in a very spoken, verbalized, oral form. So, of course, we are going to see in this part how to deal with audience, because dealing with the audience is a very complex, a very complicated issue. How to impress, how to persuade, how to speak persuasively, how to speak properly and accurately, clearly to the audience, without obstructions, without what you call any forms of distractions or any forms of miscommunications. So in this context, we are going to see two main approaches to public speaking activities. So we will be starting with sociological analysis and psychological analysis, means how to deal with the audience when you have your own speech, when you have, or you have sometimes, there are some people who are asked by certain institutions or certain association to deliver their own oral speeches. So here the speaker has to know, okay, how to deal effectively and effectually with the audience, taking into account the significance and the practicality of these two approaches, sociological and psychological approach. The third part, which is about the elements of organization. So automatically speaking, a speech is an essay, but this essay is oral, okay, it would be oral, and this oral speech will be transmitted, will be imparted to the audience. So there is a sender and there is a receiver, as we have seen in oral communication. But in public speaking right now, the speaker talking to more than three or four individuals. Sometimes he is talking to three audiences, four audiences or more, depending on the number, depending on the what you call different types and different numbers and different what you call educational level of the audience. So there are a lot of things that should be taken into account. So since it is a speech, public speaking or public speaker has to take into account the organization. So the speech should be well organized, well structured, in a very systematic, in a very what you call consistent way, in a very systematic way, taking into account the line, respecting the line or the methodology of the line of reasoning. Of course, starting with the introduction, moving to the body of the essay, and moving to the conclusion. So automatically the speaker in public speaking has to start with a thesis, okay? A thesis, what you call in the introduction, means announcing his own main and very precise objective or the aim of the speech. What is the main objective or the main behind delivering this speech? Of course, moving to something very crucial, which is highly needed and very required within public speaking activities, which is outlining. Of course, the speaker, in order to organize the thoughts and to make them in a very logical development, I mean, respecting the what you call the chronology of the thoughts, respecting the structure and the organization of the thoughts, because speaking is not like he writing, when you are speaking, the speaker or the speakers in general do not have time to organize and reorganize their own thoughts because it's something very spontaneous. So the speaker do not have time, enough time or sufficient time to organize their own thoughts. So that's why it would be better for them to make what you call certain outline. Outline means organizing thoughts in a very visual manner to help the audience, okay, in order to have more exciting and more attractive and more what you call eye-catching presentation. Of course, moving to something very important, since we are dealing now with public speaking activities and public speaking speeches, as I have said before, that public speaking is totally and eventually different from oral communication, because a speaker in the public speaking activity is talking to audience or audiences. Yeah, so public speaking is a formal face-to-face communication method where a person uses the medium of speech to inform, to influence, or a group of listeners. So there is a group of listeners and there is a speaker. So a speaker is trying to persuade, to influence, to have certain impacts on the mentalities, on the minds of the audience. And there is another definition that has been given to public speaking, and of course both definitions have been taken directly from the book that I have assigned to my own students. So in public speaking, a speaker presents a relatively continuous message to a relatively large audience in a unique context. So here it can be deduced that there are three main elements within public speaking activity. So starting with the speaker here and moving to the message, which means the meaning that the speaker is trying to send and transmit to the others, and the context. Of course, the context is very crucial, and it is at the same time very dangerous in determining the what you call the quality and the credibility of your own speech. So a context, there are different contexts. So sometimes one can see that there is a physical one, there is a cultural one, there is socioeconomic context, and there is a temporal context, there is timing and all other factors and features and factual material and factual realities that the speaker has to take into consideration before starting his own speech. So the next thing that we are going to see, so to organize your speech in a very what you call systematic order, the following skills are highly needed and extremely required for making your own speech very effectual, very efficacious, and very inspiring and very exciting to inspire and to make certain impressive speeches. So starting with planning and preparation. So since a speech, you are going to give an oral speech, the speakers have to start by planning and preparing. Preparing the speech by looking, by covering all the items, by what you call widening their own scopes concerning the theoretical knowledge that that is needed within the preparation. Taking into account the audience, the institution, the space, and the ultimate space where the would-be speech will be occurring. In addition to taking into account also the nonverbal side or the nonverbal communication, because in oral communication we have realized that a speaker sometimes uses more than three or four types of communication, starting from verbal, nonverbal, paraverbal, or haptic language. So most of the time speakers do not give certain importance, or they are not extremely aware and cautious about the importance and the significance of the nonverbal and paraverbal. Nonverbal means the body language, and paraverbal means the pitch, the pitch of the sound, the intonation, the voice, the quality of the voice, the vividness of the voice, and the other stuff that are related to what you call to the verbal one or to the voice. And the third element, which is the confidence. So public speaking ultimately obliges speakers to be self-confident and self-assured, because it's a kind what you call to overcome the stage fright. And of course, it's a psychological process. It's a psychological affair. So to help yourself to be acquainted with the fact of speaking to large audiences, of course, it needs certain psychological, cognitive, and mental preparation. Now why we are asked, or why we are obliged to study public speaking, and what are the main aims and objectives behind studying this subject within a semester? Of course, it is widely believed that public speeches are designed to either to inform, to persuade, to entertain, or speaking in a special occasions. So to start with the first aim, which means to inform. So most of public speeches have what you call certain informative reasons. And public speakers, when they are delivering their own speeches to the audience, they are trying to inform them, means sharing certain meaning. So there is data, there are certain information and certain data that should be transmitted to the audience, and the main aim here is to inform. So here, one of the explicit or one of the direct aims of public speaking is to inform students. The second one means to persuade. To persuade means in persuasive speeches, the speakers are trying to change the mind of the audience by stating, okay, his or her own arguments, supporting materials to have certain effects and certain impacts or certain influence on the mind of the audience. So trying to persuade and to impress and to what you call evoke certain changes in the mind of the attendees that are in the audience. Of course, there are different what you call occasions and different spaces and different places where speakers are asked to speak in public or speaking in public. As I have said before, it's not public speaking can happen not only in formal spaces but also in informal spaces. When you are talking to more than 3 or 4 individuals, automatically you are practicing public speaking. If you are talking like in public speaking, I think you can be divided into forms, formal and informal. Formal in public spaces, in professional spaces like in universities, in academic context, in institutions, in business interviews and in business, what you call meetings and so forth. But private or informal, sometimes you are practicing public speaking, but in a very informal way, talking to your friend, talking to more than 3 individuals and 4 individuals outside the formal arena. Yeah. So the problem now, how a speaker can empower and can enhance his own public speaking abilities and competence. So to speak persuasively, to speak competently in a very highly skilled manner, speakers, I said, have to learn and acquire certain strategies and techniques that are highly vital and highly efficacious for empowering the public speaking activities. So the ability to powerfully and persuasively impact audiences is an important part of your career and your life, because now, as I have said before, public speaking can determine your own destiny. If you have if you are skilled enough, if you have sufficient competencies in public speaking, this of course can automatically affect your own future and change your life in general, because you will have more power and more what you call vitality and more vividness and more mental and more what you call verbal powers to have what you call more effects on the individuals when you are interacting with the receiver. Yeah. Despite the emergence of new communication technology, now the need to empower speaking skills seems to be greater than ever. There is a demand for bold men and women who can really instruct, inspire, and entertain others. So inspiring the other, instructing the other, guiding the other, sometimes giving them what you call certain advice or certain guidelines or certain theoretical knowledge or details automatically forces the speaker to be extremely skilled and talented speaker. Yeah, moving to another thing which is very significant and highly interconnected with this domain of public speaking. So in public speaking, audience has a remarkable impact on the effectiveness, quality of the speech. So to analyze the audience, the following elements are crucially significant. So to prepare yourself for a very effectual, a very inspiring, a very exciting, a very striking public speech, the speakers should know the following criteria or the following points. The first one is the age, the gender, intellectual level, and social certifications, means what you call the components of the audience, because even the audience, they are numbers. Audience of course contains a number of people, individuals, or attendees, but these attendees are automatically different concerning their age, gender, intellectual level, and political or social certification. That's why why the speech will be based on the following observations. And all the speeches, the very what you call striking speeches, should cover the following items. And the best way to incite and to inspire the audience, of course, I'm talking now exactly about the audiences that contain different educational, intellectual, social, political levels. So the speech should be modified and should be edited according to the following points. Yeah, now so why students of S3 semester and people now are in need to discuss public speaking and to know the benefits of public speaking. Of course, I said that before, public speaking activities are very crucial in determining the quality of the lives of people they are going to live. So one of the main benefits of public speaking is that the first point I have divided the benefits into three or four main benefits. Of course, the first benefit to enhance your personal and social abilities, and of course you can be more self-aware. Public speaking can increase your self-awareness, your self-confidence, and your own social interaction with the other. Of course, when you are talking, of course, you will be more aware and more cautious about you, what you should do, what you should state, what you should avoid, what you should delete in your own conversations and in your own talking with the others, in addition to self-confidence, because the public speaking activities automatically empower and enhance your own self-confidence. The speakers who are frequently speaking and dealing with the audience, automatically they will have certain self-confidence, in addition to empowering social interactions or personal interaction with the other. When you are talking in public, automatically this will increase and support your own social interactions with the other. The second benefit means to improve your academic and career skills, starting from the empowering the ability of the speaker to explain and illustrate very difficult and very hard or very complicated concepts in a very clear way, without any obscurity. The second one is that you will add certain clarity and persuasiveness to your own speech, which means your speech will have more effect and more influence on the minds of the audiences. And of course, in addition to confidence and self-assurance, because as it is already stated, public speaking is one of the main mediums that the speakers have to build on in order to enhance their own self-awareness and the ability to persuade more and to inspire hugely the audience. The third element, to refine your general communication abilities. So the third benefit of public speaking now is that public speaking activities help the speakers to give more effective communication skills and giving more power and give more flexibility to deal differently and adequately with the audiences. The audiences or audience can contain different numbers and individuals. Different individuals automatically mean different mentalities and different interpretations, different concepts and different perceptions. Yeah, communicating your own credibility, since you are trying to persuade the other, to inspire them with your own speech, sometimes you are trying to increase your own credibility, to increase your own honesty, to increase your own what you call the worthwhileness of your own speech. So making your own speech very credible and very persuasive. Now the element that is the main part or the main section that is included within the first part, it's the elements of public speaking. We have seen before that in oral communication most of the time there are some very crucial and highly needed elements, starting with the sender, the channel, the messages, the receivers and the feedbacks. But in public speaking we are going going to discover other elements that are included within the public speaking process. So starting with the speaker. The speaker is crucial, is the most fundamental element within public speaking. We cannot imagine a public speaking without the speaker. Of course, the message or the meaning or the shared meanings or all the details that speakers are trying to convey, to deliver to the audience. Moving to the third point, which is channel. Channel means the media or the medium that the speaker has chosen in order to disseminate and transmit his own meanings to the others. And the noise. Of course, we have seen that in oral communication that the noise was an obstacle, okay, was a kind of barrier that may affect negatively the quality of the communication. But in public speaking, the noise is one of the components of public speaking. So you cannot imagine a public speaking activity without the existence of the noise. The noise can be physical, can be psychological, can be mental, can be cognitive, depending on your own personal social and collective situation. And the audience. Of course, the audience is an element within the public speaking process. And in this context, it's the receiver. The audience or the audiences are the receivers of the messages that have been imparted or transmitted by the speaker. Moving to the context. The context means the place or the space of interaction. And there are different types of contexts. The context can be physical, means the environment, the real environment, the real place. It can be socio-psychological, like the interaction between the supervisors and supervisors, the headmasters and the workers in any institutions, in any associations. Temporal means the timing, is it in the morning, is it in the afternoon? The timing is very crucial within this. And cultural, of course, cultural context is more dangerous, as we are going to discuss later, the interaction or the interconnection between culture and public speaking. And the delivery, in addition to the ethics. Ethics of public speaker or public speakers are very important. So to speak logically and ethically, the speaker has to take into account certain ethics. Ethics means certain points within his own personality, starting from what you call the honesty, credibility, and so on and so forth, as we are going to see later. And of course, this is the main elements of public speaking that the students should know. So we are going to discuss public speaking in general, highlighting the main points or the main elements. And all these elements will be highlighted and largely illustrated and elaborated with upcoming online sessions. And thank you.